both jammers have hit the pack. While by Fury is pushing around on the back, while Evil Beauty is out in the jersey jammer. While by Fury has escaped the pack, as Evil Beauty works her way through, calls off the jam. Classic Kitty and Kittish. Jammer up to the side and with the 3 points going up and Brandywine first to put points on the board. We have some Jammer cups on the line, Red Zeppelin and Rolling Thunder giving each other some love, which I adore to see. For the opposed to last Jammer, they're taking the back, which is more 2019. And with that whistle, both Jammers are going to cut the back for their initial pass. The first penalty of the game is Stoplock, and Skates have to be going in the right direction to even engage with other skaters. It's an amazing defense from both teams. Toronto Skaters go first, that's the first lead for Toronto. Red Zeppelin lost some points. Those Toronto Raptors holding back. Both teams are Rolling Thunder. Rolling Thunder has the hat off. It is visible. They're doing a great job on turn one, just holding her back. Rolling Thunder's going to know that from her Twitter. Her Twitter says, I'm busy hanging out with this opposing team jammer who lost my toy. Rolling Thunder's still in the pack, looking time to get out. Commander Will Wrecker getting a penalty. And also requiring a penalty in that jam. No pass. Jackie Coaching comes to block. Rolling Thunder getting out of the pack. He is not in the jammer. Red Zeppelin coming in for more points. That's one more point. That was a 5-point jam for Red Zeppelin. She looks quite happy coming out. For Toronto, Monster Muffin versus Lex Executioner for Brandywine. It looks like both jammers are still struggling to get lead, pushing near the front and up the inside is Monster Muffin. I will remember everyone's names by the end of this game, I'm sure. And Lex Executioner has escaped the pack. She's not really a jammer. Meanwhile, Monster Muffin is pushing away through. She's got two blockers left and she calls off the jam. That's 4 points for Monster Muffin. The score of this now is 9 Toronto and 3 for Brandywine. The medium tournament is an unexpected surprise given the point differential between these two teams. The rankings were not calculated in March, so you know it is May. Time does pass, but they met at the end of last year, I read, on the internet. In 2018, Toronto won by 15 points, so it's a close game. We've got Mayhem against Nina Von Teese. Nina Von Teese is in the jammer. That is 3-in-a-row lead for Toronto. Mayhem gets out, takes the hat off. Paul wanted to be a confusion blocker. It looks like, oh no, there was a attack. Bumper is your Brandywine Jammer of record. Nina Von Teese, 3 points from a call off. Pointer now 12-3 for Toronto. On the line for Toronto, we have Style by Fury versus her number 12 nemesis, Evil Beauty. That's right. Looks like we're matching up jammers so far in this game. Let's see if it shakes out. Re-jammer rotation perhaps, we will see. Style by Fury is facing out four wall at the back here. Evil Beauty is pushed away at the front and is your re-jammer for Brandywine. Style by Fury for Toronto has now escaped the pack just as Evil Beauty approaches the point. He swings around the outside and calls it off. It's short versus tall in this Rolling Thunder. This is a Toronto Vienna matchup. And so it looks like Shabam. It's Shabam wearing a hat for China. Rolling Thunder trying her best. Somebody getting called off. It's Cynthia Medica again. Two penalties already. Harper looks a little bit engaging at the head. I do not know. Bumper's got to sit. There's two in the box. Only two Brandywine blockers left. It's 30 seconds to get out for Shabam. That's some excellent work by these Brandywine skaters. Rolling Thunder around the power game for a little while. They're Rolling Thunder either returns or has 15 seconds or one. She's trying to do a pass. Very tricky for folks to block while Adana's trying to do a pass. It is a power game for Rolling Thunder. This is going to be a full 2-minute jam because there are no lead jammers when folks are in the box and when folks are picking up pass. Nice pass by Brandywine and nice blocking of Santa Marte means that Brandywine's jammer, who is now Rocket Pop, and Brandywine gets 4 points. Rocket Pop wearing a hat now. Both jammers are on the track now. This is a full 2-minute jam. I cannot remember if Shabam got out. I think she got out with firing points. So this is a little point turning around. This one is there. I've been around before. For Toronto. Oh, and I wonder if we're going to have an answer. Otherwise, we're talking. Thank you so much, Jim. Team Talk a lot and iChat for really appreciating your service. Both teams can do some amazing buildings. When you look at that, in 2 minutes of gameplay, the pack was not able to make even one rotation of the track. That is absolutely incredible. Some amazing defensive work by all blockers here today. On the line we have number 99, Lex the Future for Brandywine, and 1969, Doug Duffin for Toronto. Brandywine jammer is pushed away to the front and is battling around three blockers, while Red Duffin is at the back and is being drawn way back to the jammer line. Both jammers are having a hard time, and it looks like Brandywine's jammer is heading to the box on a four-on-one call. Toronto's jammer has escaped the pack and is coming on to points. It sounds like they have another penalty. Flat tap for someone. From Brandywine is heading to the box, and I believe it's a track that calls. Meanwhile, we're on the second square pass for Toronto. And now, I think back to the initial pass for Electrocutioner and Brandywine. She's looking sharp, she's pushing hard against that front wall, but they are holding her well. That was Get the Kick, and some other Toronto blockers doing a solid job at the front of the pack. That jam ends with well points for Toronto. Solid jam. It's our end jam on the line. Nothing a man. We got one in the box for Brandywine, so the line and get real serious for 5 seconds. Again, this is an incredible offensive game that we're seeing here. It took like a minute 40 to do a full rotation of the track. And you know, fast jammers can do that in 7 seconds. So the fact that we're holding these amazing hits by Kick Ash and Commander Low Record, bringing record to her knees and knocking with a hop and a pop. We need to pick out their friends, but she is your lead jammer. Record and Lady very dangerous move to folks are calling no pass real quickly, accompanying us, our fabulous and well-trained yesterday. Ma'am has her hat off in her hand, looking to confuse the blocker, maybe do a pass. Oh, a sneak attack pass that was not successful. Muffin continues to rack up points and kick out. And then Ma'am says, I've had enough of this, and passes to Thumper. Thumper taking the same problem that Ma'am was, and then stuck in that back there, switching off her hat. Currently no one wearing no hat, pulling it to the side, which is a rare move for a pivot. Monster says, I have enough of that, and calls it off. That was a 12-point jam for Toronto. That was the 39-15. I am terrible at math, but I can tell you that is more than double the points than the other team has. Team bad at math, right here.
That was a 12-point.
Science kitchen, that's what it is. We've got for Brandywine again, number 12, Evil Beauty on the line, facing off against Luna Von T, number 7-1. Luna Von T is off to the box with the forearm, joining you, I believe it's Commander Will Record for 15 in the box. Meanwhile, we have one blocker currently in the box for Brandywine. Speeding up, the Toronto blockers are still holding the front as the Brandywine jammer pushed their way through and is now finally your lead jammer. Alright, we've got Dexter Rabbit for Toronto heading to the box with a multiplayer. Just as Brandywine jammer, tries to sneak away at the outside and gets knocked down but continues on. Looks like Brandywine is running it long on this one. Their coach is telling them, keep on going. Meanwhile, both jammers are back in the pack and they're locked up with a pile of blockers each. Brandywine's jammer manages to sneak up the outside and Evil Beauty is coming around once more. After much effort, Toronto's jammer is out of the pack and draws a out-of-play blocking call on one of the Brandywine blockers, and that crazy jam has come to an end. But it does. That last pass got 3 points, totaling 11 points for Brandywine on that jam. 0 points for Toronto. Our score right now is 39 for Toronto to 26 for Brandywine. Roller Thunder lining up against Cryo by Fury. Small versus small. I like a good small jammer. Cryo by Fury at the front attack, pushing that pack forward, getting a little tiny bit of help from her blocker. I think it's Pitmouse is giving a little bit of help there. Cryo by Fury just knocking them down one by one. Does not... Some confusion about these jammers? I'm confused. Hat comes off the Rolling Thunder, so she can't be a lead jammer either. Who's the lead? You want one pass? It's okay, we will address. Crowd by Fury coming back. It's point time. Then the Rolling Thunder knocking Rolling Thunder at the going down herself. 23 blocking, great job of knocking Rolling Thunder just in case. Both jammers coming out of the pack now. Thunder at the front, then Titmouse. Both teams doing a great job of getting to the front after their points have been taken. Just to engage again, just to be sure and run like that. Now they're dealing with a D-dip, a few D-dips. Rolling Thunder falls behind her. It appears we have no lead, and this is going to be a natural tournament jam. And I'm going to use our wonderful tournament headmaster, to Slim Eisenhower, to that cause. Rolling Thunder just made a confused block, and they didn't even notice she was there. She picked it up. And, we have to remember that Brandywine also has a jammer here. Yes, we were kindly requested the players keep Fury in track as she is announcing tomorrow. It's our polite request for all blockers on the track.
Now the pack has slowed down. He has just come into one rotation with nearly 2 minutes. His quarterback here is showing amazing agility at speed, able to jump around these players with just one statement. Patrick may be slightly quicker, and that's 2 minutes of hard work, folks. Let's look at the board. We are going to take a small break, probably for an official review. That was a 19, the scoringest jam yet. That's what we call them in derby jams. 19 for Brandywine Academy, and for the Powell, 12, brings it to 51-45. That is a 6-point difference. Best math I can do as I point emphatically at everyone on the dais. I am good at math. One of our many lovely sponsors we have today are one of our vendors, BU wants to help you achieve a better you by combining Danbury Nail Wrap and Global Hardware Systems and a decent LCF product. BU has found a united purpose and goal to present health and beauty products, which are smart, simple, and created with you in mind. This is the official timeout. I don't know if Tillman Museum Center was bringing an official review, but it looks like it's turned. Oh, look, a tackle Smith on high school. I think Mark knows that. I think I'm going to follow a few moves. I did. I tackled the window wipeout, and keep in mind I am injured, but I remember the dance. It was.
Beautiful big finish.
Yeah. So,
looks like they
got back to the game. So, yeah. I am here to be a senior,
number 99, Lex Kuchner on the camera line for Brandywine, and Red Zeppelin on the line for Toronto.
Red Zeppelin perhaps slips over on her fellow camera and takes the combo, but that does not stop her and pushes her to the front of the pack, and she's battling with some blockers at the front.
One to go. We have Walker in the box. Walker, a blocker, is in the box for Brandywine. Just now working the phone. Alright, we have a fast pack that's suddenly slow, making it easy for Red Zeppelin to shoot through on the outside and call off. That looks like 3 points for that game. Zero for Brandywine. One thing I can tell you from my research was that Brandywine is going to play two fencing games so far this year.
Ooh.
Against Charm and Cincinnati, and from what I can tell, they lost to Cincinnati and won to Charm. Meanwhile, Toronto has played 6 times this year. Once
all
again, it appears all losses, but many of them close.
Yeah, and we are higher ranked, so I don't know who else they played, but it's not just the loss that matters in sanctioned play, it's also the points differential. I'm getting the algorithms in math, and I turn off, and I'm like, where's the start in the world, please? Looks like it was worth it for 1 point. Most of them getting 1 more point. A 10-point difference, 50 miles to 45, with 12.5 minutes left in this half. Nina Von T for Toronto against Evil Beauty for Brandywine. Beauty is stuck at the back while Nina is at the front pushing against the piano back. Oh, and she does it. She's very famous. Brandywine's blocker again is still in the back. Meanwhile, each team is sending a blocker to the penalty box. So we've now got 3-on-3. Oh. And Brandywine Scanner appears to be headed to the box. So we have a power jam for Toronto. That was a cut. And Toronto's sideline coaches are eagerly calling the power jam and urging their jammer on. We now have Brandywine's pivot to the box. And so now it looks like we have
2 walkers on for Brandywine, 3 for Toronto. Nina stuck against 1 Brandywine walker at the front of the pack, number 55, Kick Ash. But she's out and she's coming back around for play. Two jammers back on the track, it looks like, and both are stuck in a 3 wall. One Toronto blocker is keeping that whole group packed together while everyone sort of mushes together trying to get their jammer out. We've had a Toronto blocker get into the box. And the bench is yelling to call, and that is that.
Time to
getting to the Derby, we had this toll bridge as a way to actually stop.
I think I was also taught that statement.
Because we were interested in breaking more of our ankles. Yeah, and I get terrified every time I see, whoa, Shabam, taking a run at this. As Mayhem winds up right with his hold on the line, Shabam wants to sneak attack those Brandywine blockers. Brandywine at the front, Shabam at the back, and see that set up a couple of times, and it works for Mayhem. He's going to need Jenna. Shabam dealing with those black blockers at the front. The folks in my room were sort of quite small. We are quite a smiling team today. So everyone looks like giants to me here. Mayhem calling out after one point that we've seen all game super effective defensive work from the tunnel blocker.
Coming back to the bench, Shabam just looked super pumped, high-fiving her benchmates and celebrating and having a chance to see some joy in these otherwise tense scenarios. On the line right now for Brandywine, we have number 12, Evil Beauty. And it looks like that monster muffin, I'm going to say, for Toronto. She's quite bent over, but doing a sweet onesie.
She made it herself!
Oh, that's a beauty.
Oh my gosh, that, I love, she's doing this last season in South Carolina, and I was admiring it too. It being unicorn with a low back and then a crop top. Oh, so good.
It's a ball and look.
Maybe it's not that I think they're not much better than the others, but I'm like, when somebody was a senior, I'm like, what's that?
A combination of athleticism and style still is deep in my heart.
10 out of 10. No notes.
On that note, she has, I think it's, she's escaped the pack. She is coming back around. Meanwhile, the blockers all try to slow down to fly and help those camera not have to work so hard. She is still working away at the front. Two solid Brandywine blockers keeping her back, but she makes it out. A Brandywine blocker gets blocking out of play call. Meanwhile, Monster Blocker is coming back around. And so is Brandywine's game. Evil Beauty has just shooted up the outside. But Monster Muffin gets out of the pack and calls it. And that, my friends, is a deal.
Little more than 3 minutes left in this half. Toronto approaching the century mark with 87 points. Brandywine at 56. Rolling Thunder against Nina Von Keys. One Brandywine skater in the box. And in the last one we have Tri-City against Rochester. I know that many of my teammates are making the epic half-hour trip from Guelph to see that game. Meanwhile, the future lead winner, Roland Thunder, stuck at their back again. I think that world record Rochester combination was quite well. World record is hit at 1-1. Rolling Thunder is able to do the easy kick, easy surge. And Nina Richardson did an excellent communication with her bench. That pass was 0-0, but Nina picked up 4 points this round, 91-56. 2.5 minutes left in this half.
Well, this is shaping up for an exciting game.
Totally. It's really interesting with these sanction games. Close people are ranked, close teams are ranked.
On the line for Toronto, we have Trial by Fury, and she is facing off again. Alright, looks like we got Jack and Pat off for a forearm for Brandywine. Meanwhile, Brandywine scammer number 99, Electrocution, appears to be a new scammer. And she has called it out for 3 points.
Brandywine is taking points on the board. 2 points is nice to get some momentum. It feels good for the whole team to feel like, oh, we're going somewhere. second in place. Mayhem against Rick Whitman. Rick Whitman getting some help from Titmouse. Titmouse making sure the pack isn't broken as Mayhem tries to push that strong wall of the Counterbacker's forward. Dinner. Donald Crane's up in the front. Mayhem getting a cutting penalty. It is another power jam. And I think she was an instable nation as well. It is a 4 minute for Donald to do his continues. And what they will do is turn left. Red coming up to points. Toronto getting a goat. Trying to help out and then leaving that goat. That one player there holding back to make the pack to do a little bit of fencing work. Red Wine taking advantage of this and drawing that demo back. 69 doing a great job at the front there. We're trying to see the captain of Red Wine doing a great job at the front, waiting for that demo, knowing that she's going to move forward eventually. Someone has a full complement of blockers to deal with Red Zeppelin. And Kendall Warlock is getting in there, making things up, trying to break up that pack. It is a very effective strategy, leaving Red Zeppelin to keep the round blockers one at a time. Brady returns to attack to help her jammer out. Red Zeppelin says, is this serving? This is tiring. 4 more points. That makes it a 15-point jam so far. Gotta break that century mark. Gets over the 100. Both jammers are on the track. And Red Zeppelin calls it off as she's on one leg and falling out as she gets one last point. That is the half. The score is, it should be, I think, 108-59, but let's see what happens to that last demo play. Might be 107-59. We're going to take a 15-minute break. Check out all the wonderful bearings that folks have to sale. I need to buy some new bearings. I believe there are adult beverages available, and we will be back for more goodies.
Thank you.
to the team whether it is illegal, so thank you. and then back to the drain. So you have to wait for the last moment to either pivot, center, or just take a seat in Canada. And that is the game. Thank you.
The first thing is Facebook.com/dirty